He's the director of the Rockford Regional Office of the Better Business Bureau. Did I get that right, Dennis?
You got it right, Riley. How are you?
Good, man. How are you doing this morning?
Very good. It's a beautiful day.
It is a beautiful day, and it's a beautiful day to, well, to help people out. That's what the Better Business Bureau is all about. And if you pay attention to these segments, then we follow up with a Facebook post and the audio and all that. You can avoid some things out there where people are trying to liberate you from your money. Sweepstakes and lottery scams.
We are, this morning, a little background. We have an international investigator. His name is Stephen Baker, and he does deep dive investigations on scams of all nature for a consortium of five larger Better Business Bureaus, including Chicago, which includes us. And he has done a study over the past several months that looked at sweepstakes and lottery prize schemes and determined that millions, 117 million dollars were lost last year.
Wow.
And the huge problem is that the individuals targeted most and who lose the most are senior citizens, people between 65 years old and 74 years old. And today we are releasing that study. It's been embargoed for last week to let people know about it. And we're hearing it now for the first time to people in Rockford.
You know, it's amazing, Dennis, and you and I have talked about this before. Senior citizens have such a bullseye on their back from scam artists.
I often talk about that, and you and I have discussed it many times. And I think occasionally I oversimplify it by saying senior citizens become the targets because they are at home for many of the schemes that are door-to-door. But for this situation, they become the target because they are being sought out, that phone calls and mail to their homes and those who are online, email, and those who are on Facebook and the like, they are literally being targeted.
Yep, because people know that's where the money is in some cases, and sadly in other cases, if they're taken for money, they're a part of their segment of the population that isn't going to be so quick to pipe up about it for fear of having their life pulled away from them. You can't make proper decisions anymore, Mom, Dad. We're going to take away the card. We're going to take away this. We're going to limit your independence, and it all becomes a mess.
That is so true, and one of the reasons that they tend to fall for it is because many of the seniors who have become victims are on fixed incomes, they're on Social Security or a pension, and they're concerned about money. And when they receive this phone call, for instance, a local person, and she won't mind my using her name, Mrs. Helen Finnegan, she received one of those phone calls, and during our conversation, she told me just how good these people are at convincing, and in this case, it was her husband, and frankly, fortunately, she overheard the conversation and stepped in, and they discussed it to find out that, in fact, there wasn't going to be a million-dollar sweepstakes win for them. But when you are concerned about your retirement, whether or not you're going to have enough money to live in a lifestyle that you're happy with, it becomes what could be manna from heaven for you.
Absolutely, a desperate situation.
Right. So that's one of the things that we are very concerned about. In fact, we're doing a news conference today at 10:30, and we're being joined by the U.S. Postal Inspection. Service. Mr. Ben Weller will be here, along with a representative from the Northwest Illinois Agency on Aging, to talk about this because it is a scam and schemes that can be very devastating to senior citizens.
Oh, I'd read about a guy out in California, I think within the last year, maybe two at the most, who the one that got him was supposedly some sweepstakes in Ireland that he had won. And, you know, first off, I think it's the law. Americans can't take part in foreign lotteries or foreign sweepstakes.
That is correct.
And he didn't realize this, and they told him he'd won several million, and not unlike the Nigerian letter scam, we're just going to need this from you, we're going to need that from you, we're going to need this fee, we're going to need that fee. Well, when all was said and done, the guy was out $250,000, and there were no Irish sweepstakes for him to win.
Exactly. And again, you mentioned the Nigerian letter scam. These sweepstakes scams tend to originate in Jamaica, Costa Rica, and Nigeria. So it's big money for them. And we're very often asked, why can't you do something about it? Well, there are efforts. You know, this study is in part done so that law enforcement can really track the number of people who are victims and find out where most of the activity is coming from. And as I mentioned, it's Jamaica, Costa Rica, and Nigeria. And then they can work with foreign law enforcement officials to try to track down the perpetrators of these crimes.
The problem being, as always, it's in another country. You have to rely on the support of that other country. If we don't have treaties and extradition and all those other things, you know, you're just spitting in the wind, because there's really nothing. They're as close to being untouchable as somebody can be.
Exactly. And they also use the names of well-known sweepstakes, like the Publishers Clearinghouse sweepstakes. It's legitimate. They may not call it exactly that, but it sounds so much like it that it lures people in and they fall for it. So one of the things that we always are saying is, one, you cannot participate in foreign lotteries because the IRS laws don't permit that. Also, true lotteries or sweepstakes don't ever ask you for money. You don't have to put up any money, not so much as a stamp, to participate in those. So anytime you get a phone call or an email or anything that requires you to pay any amount of money, 2 cents or $2,000, it's a scam.
I can see where people would, you know, get it. Well, oh, sure, it's just a small fee. I've won $5 million. I mean, what's a few grand out of that?
Right, and you mentioned earlier, Riley, that it happens to people, and because they fall for it, they're too embarrassed to say anything about it. We really would like to change that dynamic, that if you become a victim, please let someone know so that we can inform law enforcement, and we can may not be able to help you get your money back, but we can prevent or try to prevent others from becoming victims.
Right, and you know, I'm sure it's a small solace if you're out a whole bunch of money, but you're not the only person that this has ever happened to. So
exactly.
The idea of, oh, I can't let people know how stupid I am, don't look at it like that. Look at it as trying to head it off before someone else gets scammed by these people, because they're going to move on to the next victim right down the road.
Right, and we advise everybody, if you get, and you're not quite sure whether or not this is a legitimate sweepstakes offer or not, give us a call. Or if not, talk to us, talk to a family member or someone else that you trust so that they can look at it as well, so that you aren't, you know, operating in a vacuum by yourself trying to decide whether or not this is legitimate or not. Share that information with someone else.
How do people get in touch with you, Dennis?
You can give us a call at area code 815-963-2222 or go online to bbb.org.